It's time for another episode of the Faith Fight Podcast. Today, it's time to stand strong in the battle. Hello, everyone. Thank you for tuning into this episode of the Faith Fight Podcast. My name is Chris Creary, and I'm here to help you get your prayers answered, to encourage you to grow from glory to glory, and to ultimately assist you in achieving your God-given purpose. Thank you for taking time out of your day. I know you could be doing anything else right now, but instead you have chosen to listen to this podcast. So I am grateful for you deciding to spend a portion of your day with me. And I'm praying that this episode blesses you and helps you to grow to who God has called you to be. For those of you listening for the first time, I want to give you a special warm welcome. I'm thankful for you specifically today. And I'm letting you know that this podcast is available on all of the major podcasting apps. It's on Spotify, Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, Amazon Music, Audible, iHeartRadio, and it's on CastBox now. So if you use any of those apps to listen to podcasts, just search for the Faith Fight Podcast and you'll be able to find this podcast, subscribe, and get every future episode that I release on a Sunday morning. And also, I have an archive of over 260 episodes that I've been doing for the past 5 years. So if there's anything that is challenging you and you need to find Bible verses to stand on to build your faith, or if you want me to stand in agreement in prayer, you can listen to any one of the past episodes and just go to the different topic titles and download and listen to any one of those episodes. They will encourage you, they will bless you, and they will help you get the answers to the prayers that you are believing God for. So for those returning listeners, I want to thank you as well. Thank you for coming back and listening to the Faith Fight Podcast. But I'm going to ask you to do something. I'm going to ask you to share this podcast with someone else so that they can be blessed by what we talk about today. Hey everyone, just before we get into this episode, I want to let you know about my new podcast. It's called I Made a Podcast, and it's about podcasting. So if you have a podcast already, or if you had the idea to try and start a podcast, then this new show will help you. In this new show, I interview podcasters from around the world, and we talk about how they make a podcast. They go over some of the tools, the tricks, and some of the resources that they use so that we can all learn more about podcasting. So if you're interested in starting a podcast, go check out my new podcast. I'm guaranteeing you that you will learn something new and be encouraged to start your podcast in this year. And if you're looking for new podcasts to listen to, this will be a good way to be introduced to new shows as well. So you can check out my new podcast. It's called I Made a Podcast, available on all of the major podcasts and apps out there. And I made it easy for you. There's a link in the description of this episode that you can go to and directly go to the podcast. So thanks for listening. And now let's get back to the Faith Fight Podcast. All right, everyone, thanks for tuning in today to the podcast. I'm just going to pray today for everyone out there who's standing strong in the battle and that God will empower you to continue to stand strong. So what I'm going to ask for you to do is just agree with me as I pray concerning this topic. So Heavenly Father, we just want to say thank you for your amazing love, your grace, and your mercies. Thank you, Heavenly Father, as we come before your presence right now, God, boldly and confidently by the blood of Jesus. You are the Most High God. You are the Elohim, the El Shaddai, the one, O God, who reigns, who sits high and looks low. And I thank you, Father God, that you have created every single one of us for your divine purpose, Lord God. And I thank you for this moment that we have together, O God, that we may pray, that we may seek after you, O God, and that we may call down your heavenly host to fight in the battle for us, Lord God. You are the Most High God. You are sovereign, Lord God. And we stand firm in our confidence, O God, knowing that you are able to help us, knowing that you are able to strengthen us, Lord God, knowing, O God, that we win the battle, O God, because you are on our side, Lord God. So I thank you as we approach your throne of grace right now, Lord God, and we boldly come before you. Heavenly Father, I ask you for grace and mercies to be extended to every single person here, Lord God. You know we are just flesh, Lord God, and we may have failed you in so many different ways up to this point in our lives, Lord God. But Lord, thank you for Jesus. Thank you for the sacrifice he paid for us, Lord God, and for the price that he paid on the cross, and that we may boldly come before your presence because of him. So Lord, in the name of Jesus, we pray for a fresh cleansing with the blood of Jesus right now, oh God. Purify our hearts and our minds as we approach your throne of grace right now. And I thank you, Lord God, that it's because of Jesus that we may boldly approach you, Lord God. Your word says that we may confidently and boldly approach your throne of grace in time of need, Lord God. So I thank you that time is now, Lord God. Have mercy upon us. Forgive us, Lord God. And I thank you, Father, for your love that knows no end, Lord God. Your love that endures forever, Lord God. And I thank you that because of Jesus, he has bridged the gap that we may have a relationship with you, that we may come to you in prayer, Lord God, that we may present our request towards you, Lord God, knowing that you will hear us, O God, as we approach in his name, O God, and in his righteousness. So we thank you and celebrate the victory that we have won in Jesus, Lord God. And I thank you, Father God, for all that you have done for us. And as we come before your presence right now, as you have laid it upon my heart, I am praying for every single person that is standing strong in a battle right now, Lord God. I thank you, Lord God, that you will continue to strengthen them and uphold them with your mighty right hand, Lord God. I pray for them, Lord God, and I thank you that your word gives us promises, O God, that no weapon formed against us will ever prevail, Lord God. And every single tongue that rises up against us, O God, we will condemn, O God. And this is the heritage of the saints of the Lord. And I thank you, Lord God, as your word says in Isaiah 54:17, O God, whatever the plan that the enemy has to come against us, O God, it will not prosper, Lord God. But we will be victorious, O God. We will rise up higher, O God, than the enemy has, O God, and persevere over the attack and over the trial that the devil has tried to come to put in our way, Lord God. We, O God, will continue to keep our eyes fixed upon you, Lord God, knowing that you are the author and the finisher of our faith, Lord God. And I thank you, Lord God, that this is your word, O God, and we thank you and we stand upon your word. So we give you the praise and the glory for what it says, O God, in Hebrews 12. So therefore, as we are surrounded by a great cloud of witnesses, O God, we throw off every single thing that hinders us and every sin that entangles us, Lord God, and we run this race with perseverance, O God. We run this race, O God, that you have marked out for us, O God, seeking you daily, O God, and inquiring of your Holy Spirit to direct us every single day, that we may be victorious, O God, and finish well, that we may finish strong, Lord God, and complete the work that you have for us, O God. And I thank you, Father God, for the joy set before us, O God, because we know we are victorious, Lord God, in Jesus. We know that we will triumph over the enemy, O God, because as your word says in 1 Corinthians 15:57, thanks be to God who gives us the victory through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. So we give you the praise and the glory for this, Lord God, and we thank you, Lord God, that we are more than conquerors, Lord God, that we, O God, have the victory in Jesus, and we give you all honor and all praise right now, Lord God. We are more than conquerors because of what it says in Romans 8:37, Lord God. So Lord God, I thank you that you have given us power to trample upon every single snake and scorpion, every single plan, assignment, and attack of the enemy, O God. I pray that you will empower your children right now, Lord God, to take authority and dominion over those plans of the enemy, Lord God. Your word says that you have given us power all over all of the enemy's ability, Lord God. So we thank you, Father God, that we, O God, when we are standing in our God-given authority, O God, have power over the enemy, Lord God. We have power over every single plan and assignment, Lord God. And I thank you that you are faithful, Lord God. And I give you praise and glory, Lord God, and I give you the honor, Lord God, because you, O God, have wonderfully created this plan for us to follow, O God. So as we submit to you, Lord God, I thank you that your perfect will shall be done in our lives, Lord God. Give us discernment and understanding to understand the spirit that is in operation concerning the opposition that is coming against us, Lord God. And we thank you and we condemn it right now in the name of Jesus. We come against every single plan and assignment of the enemy and that spirit of the enemy trying to, oh God, to stop your people from allowing your purpose to be done in their lives, Lord God. We come against it now. And I thank you, Father God, that your Holy Spirit will reveal the spirit that is in operation, oh God, against your children, Lord God, that we may declare and speak against it and speak your word over it in the name of Jesus. And we thank you, Lord God, that if you are for us, who can be against us, oh God? This is Romans 8:31, Lord God. So we stand firm knowing, oh God, that there is no plan or assignment or no person under the operation of the enemy that can come against us, oh God, because if you are for us, oh God, Who can be against us? The answer is no one can be against us, Lord God, because you are for us. So we thank you, Lord God. Who is like you, Lord God Almighty, the Lord God of angel armies, Lord God? And I thank you that you surround us with faithfulness, Lord God, and your love. And I thank you, Father God, that is surrounding your people today, Lord God. I pray that you are glorified, and I thank you, Father God, for all that you've done in us and through us. And I ask, oh God, that you will continue to hear our prayer every single day, Lord God, as we make our requests up unto you, oh God, every single day. I thank you, Lord God, that you will hear our prayer, and I thank you that you will answer. And the answer, oh God, though it may not be what we want, I thank you that you, oh God, in your providence and in your sovereignty, that you will work out the situation for every single person listening, Lord God. So whether it is we need to learn something, Lord God, in order to go into the promise, Lord God, or if we need to be patient, oh God, until we receive the promise, Lord God, I thank you, Lord God, that your will shall be done. And if there is something preventing us from getting into that promise right now, Lord God, I pray that those things, those blockages and those hindrances from the pit of hell be removed in the name of Jesus. I thank you for the anointing of the Holy Spirit, Lord God, and this anointing is a yoke-breaking anointing. And I pray, Lord God, that every single blockage and every single yoke trying to keep us yoked to the past, oh God, is broken in the name of Jesus. I thank you that we will throw off the chains and throw off the yoke, oh God, and the things that have kept us back in our past, Lord God. But you, oh God, in your love and your sovereignty, oh God, will allow us to walk into the promise and walk into the blessing, Lord God, because we know that you have good things for us. You said in John 10:10 that the thief comes to steal, kill, and destroy. But you have come, Jesus, to give us life and give us life to the fullest. So we expect, oh God, it right now in the name of Jesus. We expect, oh God, blessings. We expect abundant life, Lord God. We expect every single problem, issue, oh God, to be submitted to the will of Jesus Christ so that the abundant life, oh God, will come to us and every assignment of the enemy to steal, kill, and destroy will be demolished in the name of Jesus. I pray for every single person right now in the battle, Lord God, that you will give them discernment, Lord God, so that they will know the right decision that they need to take, oh God. That they will know, oh God, whether they need to go to the left or to the right, Lord God. And I pray that you will expose every single false step, oh God, and every single pitfall that the enemy may try to put in front of them, Lord God. And every single deceptive scheme, oh God, that the enemy may try to confuse them, oh God. Father, your word says that you are not the author of confusion, Lord God. So, Father God, may you lead us with your peace. And I thank you, Father, because you are faithful to do this in your love towards us, Lord God. That you have good things for us, oh God, plans to prosper us and not to harm us, to give us hope and an expected end, Lord God. So we expect prosperity. We expect blessings, oh God. We expect peace, Lord God. We expect dominion and power, Lord God, because this is how you've created us, Lord God. So we thank you right now, Lord God, and we give you the glory for all the good things that you are going to do in our lives. You are a good Father. You are the Most High God, and we could say give thanks to the Lord, for his love endures forever. Your love endures forever, Lord God, and we will not be swayed. We will not be moved, Lord God, or convinced otherwise, Lord God, but you are working everything out according to your divine love for us, Lord God. So we thank you right now, O God. We pray, O God, that you will continue to hear our prayers. We continue to press in. We will not give up. We will not give in, but we will continue to pray and continue to press in, Lord God. And I thank you, Lord God, and I speak to every single assignment that may be trying to come against your people right now. And I don't bring any single railing argument towards it, but I say the Lord rebuke you, Satan. And I declare that God's will be done in the lives of your people. So have your way in our lives, Almighty God. And I thank you that you will sit upon the throne of our hearts, O God, and lead us, O God, according to your divine will and purpose in our lives, Lord God. And your name will be glorified, your name will be exalted, and your glory shall come on the earth. And may everybody see your goodness that you are operating through us, Lord God. And may it draw people closer to you, Father God. And as we submit, O God, to your Holy Spirit, I thank you that you are faithful, Lord God, to allow it to work all things out for the good. So we humbly submit to you, Lord God, though the things may not be good while we're going through it, we thank you that they will work out for the good. And we give you the praise and the glory for this in the name of Jesus. We thank you for hearing our prayer right now. And again, strengthen my brother and my sister listening right now. Strengthen them as they go through the battle. Uphold them, oh God. And I pray that you will encourage their spirit, oh God. Speak to their hearts, Lord God, when they're going through a tough time. And I thank you, Father, that you are faithful and your love endures forever. In Jesus' name, we thank you and we pray. Amen. And that's it for this episode of the Faith Fight Podcast. I hope that you were encouraged. I hope that you were blessed. I pray that you were strengthened and that you received some encouragement through this episode so that you can continue to stand firm in the battle. And after you have done all that you can do to stand, continue to stand in Christ Jesus and you will see the victory. Now, if you were blessed by this episode of the podcast, you can go over to Apple Podcasts and you can subscribe there and you can leave a review. For anyone else who is wondering if they should listen to this podcast, they will see your review and it will be a blessing to them to see what you have to say about this podcast, how it encouraged you. So leave a 5-star review and you can even write your testimony in the little comment section. And if you have an Android phone, you can go on to the podcast through Google Podcasts, Spotify, Amazon Music, Audible, CastBox, iHeartRadio. Basically, any podcasting app out there, you can search the Faith Fight Podcast and you can find this podcast. So put a 5-star review and put a rating in there on whichever app that you're using so that other people will be able to find this podcast and be encouraged by the message that I'm sharing here for God's glory. And I ask you to share this with someone else if you think that they will be blessed by it. If they're going through a tough battle right now, share this with them so that they can listen, pray along with me, and be encouraged. And we will all be victorious and see the manifested victory that Jesus has paid for on the cross in our lives. And remember to put on the full armor of Christ Jesus every single day and go out and fight the good fight of faith. And you'll hear from me again next week on the Faith Fight Podcast. Something good is happening to you today. You are blessed.